Hey guys, welcome back to FedEx Gaming's Redstone Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'm showing you guys how to build my 9-button combination lock. Now, I built this because after I built my 4-button combination lock, a lot of people were asking for a 9-button one. This one is exactly the same as the 4-button, except it's 9 buttons. Also, the people that were asking for the 9-button combination lock, to those people that replied to those people to go check out my ATM video, I would like to say thank you because that was definitely the right place to send people. Of course, you know, you don't have people that always check out all your videos, but yes, they sent you to the right spot. However, this one is a lot different from my ATM video one. This one can have an infinite amount of numbers. Now, my combination is only going to be 9 numbers long, but you can have up to 100 numbers if you really want to. But you know, you got to be wary of redstone lock on the console and all that good stuff. So I'm going to punch in my number here. That iron door is going to open up, and then I'm pretty much just going to show you the redstone over there, and then we're going to build it. So my combination is 7159826692. So let's put that in. So 7159826992. And our door opens up. And we can go ahead inside our door. We could click this button to close door. Of course, the button doesn't have to be up there. I'm gonna show you how to, because pretty much this build is you need to know inputs and outputs. Like I said on the 4-button one, if you don't know inputs and outputs, then I highly recommend not building this. And then of course, if you want to leave this, you can go out like this and you are done. Now of course, if you put the wrong combination in, like if I put like, so let's say like 3, as you can see, a bunch of blocks pop up on this side and none pop up on this side, because every time we put in the wrong combination, this side goes up and this will reset everything. So I put a 3 in, and now let's say I put in a 7. See how it just pretty much reset everything? You have to put the right numbers in the right order, or it will not work. And of course, there is also a reset switch if you would like to reset it. All right, guys, so let's just start building this thing. Like I said, if you've built my 4-button combination lock, it's the exact same thing, but with 9 buttons. So let's just start building this thing, guys. Alright guys, so just like my 4-button combination lock tutorial, I am not going to be giving a definite spacing for this build because it is big. If you're going to build this thing, then you just need to have a lot of room. If you don't have a lot of room, then I highly recommend not building, because this thing, like I said, you can make it as long as you want. You can have like 50 buttons on this thing, as long as you can remember your own combination. That's another thing. You have to remember your own combination. But the good thing about this build is you're only going to need one sticky piston. You need a lot of repeaters though. So we're going to start building this thing by putting in our keypad first. So pretty much all you're gonna do is make a 3x3. So just make a 3x3 like that, and then put buttons all along it. And this is gonna be our keypad. Like that. Next, we're gonna swing to the backhand side of our keypad, and we're gonna put torches all along the entire keypad. And then we're gonna do the first torch right here. We're gonna do number 8. We're gonna dig down a block and then dig over 4 more actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So come 3 out from the keypad. We're gonna put redstone dust right underneath this torch. Put a repeater coming out of it on 1-tick delay, and then bring 3 more pieces of redstone dust like that. And we're gonna come back to that one at the end. Next, coming out of these 2 torches right here, we're gonna come out with dust here and here, and then put a repeater coming out of the dust on 1-tick delay. Next, we're gonna put a block in between these 2 pieces of dust with redstone dust on top of that. They're gonna connect together, and we don't want that, so we're gonna put 2 blocks like this, disconnecting those redstone dust. And then we're gonna put a repeater coming out of this block set to 1-tick delay. Next, we're gonna do these torches right here, this one and this one. So it should be 5 and 6. No, 4 and 6, sorry. So we're gonna come out from this torch right here with a block, put a repeater coming out of the torch on 1-tick delay, put a block next to that with redstone dust here, and then we're gonna put 2 repeaters coming out of that on 1-tick delay. And we're gonna do the same thing on this side. So put a block right above this redstone dust, and then another one, put a repeater coming out of this torch on 1-tick delay, put a piece of redstone dust in front of it, and then coming out of this block, we're gonna come out with 2 repeaters like that. Next, we're gonna do these 2 top torches right here, this one and this one. So next, what you're gonna do is just put redstone dust here and here. They're gonna connect together. We don't want that. So we're just gonna put a block right here in the middle, disconnecting them. Come down a block on both sides, making pretty much like a nice pyramid. Come down redstone dust here and here, and then just come out with a repeater right there and right there. Next, what you can actually do is over here where we dug down this redstone dust, just come up one with the dust and then put a repeater coming out of that dust as well. Next, we have to do the last button, which is this torch right here. So what you're gonna do is just put a block right above the torch, and then we're gonna come out 2 more, 1, 2, to the left of it, put redstone dust up here, Then coming out of the redstone dust, we're gonna put, actually, if you want to, you can put a repeater here, but if you don't wanna put a repeater here, you can actually delete this block and put a half slab here. Well, a slab. You can put a slab upside down right here with dust. If you're doing this on survival, you could save a repeater by doing that. So I'm just gonna do that if you want to. Or like I said, if you wanna just put a block and a repeater, you could do that as well. But I'm gonna do the slab. Next, what we're gonna do is just come down from that, like that. Just a nice little staircase all the way down and wrap it around like that and just bring the dust all the way down. And then put a repeater coming out of the redstone dust. So that should be all our numbers done. Every single number should be right here. So, you know, if I click this, that one goes off. So, you know, actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video here. And then I'm going to put the numbers up here so I can show you guys where each number is for each repeater. So you don't get, confused while building this. So I'm going to stop the video here and I'm going to do the numbers. All right, guys, so I just got done putting each number over each designated repeater. As you can see, they are not in order. They are just all jumbled up because that is the order of how we are clicking it on the keypad. So as you can see where one is right here, when I click one on the keypad, the repeater underneath one goes off. See that? So this is the order you're gonna need. 8, 4, 1, 7, 5, 9, 3, 6, and then 2. I highly recommend doing this if you are gonna make your combination lock like 10 numbers or like 8 numbers. It will really help you out instead of having to go back to the keypad, clicking the button to look where you have to go. It will just make things go a lot faster. So now pretty much what we're going to do is dig out our numbers. Now I'm gonna be doing 9 numbers because that's what I showed in the beginning. I have 9 numbers on my combination lock. So that's what I'm gonna show in the tutorial. So pretty much all we're gonna have to do is in front of these repeaters, we're gonna have to dig down 2 in front of each repeater. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Gonna keep repeating myself. And that is one number on our combination. So pretty much I'm gonna have to do this 8 more times. So I'm gonna pretty much just speed up the video here. We're gonna do this 8 more times. So here we go, guys. And there we have it, you guys. We have all 9 spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, like I said, you don't have to make it this big. You can make it smaller and you can make it much larger if you want. But remember, each area we dug out is going to be one number for our combination. Now, in between each area we dug out on these lines right here, we're going to put more repeaters facing towards the back. So take out your repeaters and then on one tick delay, just put all your repeaters going towards the back like so. Just put repeaters all in between each and every single line right here. There we go. It's just like my 4 button combination lock, except it's just a lot bigger. There we go. And that should be the last one. Nope, last one's right here. And there we have it, guys. So now we got the repeaters in between each one. Now this is where we're gonna figure out what numbers we want for our combination lock. Now I'm gonna be using the one I used in the beginning. I'm gonna be using 7159826 92. You can use whatever number you want here, but remember, you're gonna have to pick whatever. You just gotta remember your number. So I highly recommend getting a sign out or something and then putting your number down first and then installing it into your build, because you really don't want to forget it if you're making it really big. So now, like I said, I'm making mine 7 1. So right here's where the 7 is. As you can see, if I click 7 on the keypad right here, this repeater goes off underneath the 7. So your combination, pretty much the numbers go from the back to the front. The combination doesn't start from here, it starts from the back. So as we could see, 7 is here, so I'm gonna have to go all the way back here. I just have to remember where my 7 is, and then right in front of the repeater that the 7's at, we're gonna put a block down here with redstone dust on top of it. So that's where our 7 block's gonna be. So that's our first number. Now I'm gonna do 1. So 1 is right here. So I'm gonna follow 1 all the way to the back. And then right here, 1 line below 7, we're gonna put our 1 block right here. You can do the same combination as me too if you want. I don't really care. It really is all depends on you guys. You know, it's a very big build, honestly. So we're gonna do 7, 1, now 5. Let's find 5, there's 5. So now we just follow 5 all the way to the back. We come 1 line down from 1 and we put a block up with a piece of dust in here. So that's 7, 1, 5, 9 is the next one. So 9 is right here, it should be right here. Oh, wait, one more over there, we go. So we're gonna follow 9 all the way to the back. So we're gonna put a block down right here with redstone dust. 7, 1, 5, 9, 8 is the next one. So 8 is over here. So we're just gonna follow 8 all the way down. And there's 9 right there. So we're gonna put our 8 block right here. 71598, now 2692, which is actually really easy. I remember 2692. So here's our two. We just follow our two down. So there's our eight. We're gonna put our two right here. Our six is actually gonna be right here, but I'm gonna just show you it anyway. Two, there's our six. We're gonna put our six block right here, like so. And then nine should be right here again. So our nine goes right here. And then two is right here. So we're just gonna put two down right there. And that's gonna be our whole entire combination lock. Next, what you wanna do is dig out two more going towards the right on each individual line. So two more. Like this. Here we go. A lot of digging. So there we go. Now what I want you to do is pretty much put a block up all the way here at the end where we just dug out. And then we're gonna put a torch on top of each one of these blocks. Like that. Now what I want you to do is from where every single block you have up here with the redstone dust, you're gonna bring a line of redstone dust going all the way to this torch. So pretty much just take your redstone dust from this block and bring it all the way to the torch like that on each line. So just bring it all the way to the torch. Ooh, don't tick that, there we go. All the way to the torch. There we go. Ooh. There we go. Bring it all the way to the torch. All the way to the torch. All the way to the torch. The torch, and there we go. So now we got each line at every single torch. Now what I want you to do is take out your blocks again, and we're gonna put lines in front of each one of these repeaters, except for the blocks right above the dust, and I'll pretty much, you'll know why when we get towards the end. So pretty much just put blocks right in front. So wherever the redstone dust is though, delete that block. Wherever your redstone dust is, just delete that block right above it and then fill the rest of the lines in. If you can understand that. So pretty much just put your line in and then where the redstone dust is, delete that block. We're gonna be putting it back. It's just, it's gonna make it a lot easier on us later on. So like I said, wherever that redstone dust is, delete the block and then put it in. Go. Wherever the redstone dust is, delete the block so that one gets deleted. Go. The redstone block's here, delete it. Make sure you delete that block. Trust me, it's gonna help you out once you get towards the end. Well, not towards the end, it's gonna help you out pretty much right after this part. It's gonna help a lot. So we're gonna put these blocks in. Delete that block right above the redstone dust. There we go, we only got two more to go. It's very annoying, but trust me, it's all well worth it once you're done. Go, delete that. That doesn't need to be there. And the last line right here. Now the whole reason we delete across every single block right here, because now we have to put torches above every single one of these blocks. So take out your torches, and we're gonna be putting torches along all these blocks. Now the reason why I deleted that block right there is because that's the only block we're not supposed to have a torch on. If we left that block there, then we'd have to go underneath, figure out where the block is, delete it, and it just gets very annoying and tedious. So as long as it's deleted, we could just put in all our torches without having to worry about that block. Then once all your torches are in, now that all your torches are in, go back to that spot where we deleted those blocks and just put them back in. I usually put two blocks up like that, just so you can remember where it is, like that. So just put two blocks up along each one. There we go. Go, and there we go. Now wherever we put up two blocks right there, that's our code. So this right here is the 7, you know, the 1, the 5, and yada yada, so on and so forth. That's our code right there. So next what I want you to do is above all these torches over here at the ends. Ooh, I didn't put this block in actually. Oh, I didn't put any torches here actually. Look at that. If you put those things, remember to put torches here as well. I completely forgot about these torches as well. All right, guys, so after sleeping off the third night already, because this build is extremely long, I just went ahead and I put numbers across each one of these blocks, just as a reminder of what my combination is. Like I said, each little note, like to leave yourself to remember your combination, helps out in the long run. So I just went ahead and did that really quick. So next, what we're going to do is right above each one of these off torches, we're going to take out our regular pistons, and we're going to put a regular piston above each one of our off torches that are down in this hole right here. So there should be 9 regular pistons facing upwards after the last torch. So come on. So annoying. There we go. And boom. Next, what I want you to do is put a piece of sand above each one, or you can use gravel, doesn't really matter. sand or gravel. Then in between each piece of sand or gravel, whatever you're using, put another block, like so. Stop that. Like that, and then off the back one, we're gonna put two blocks, one, two. Then here, we're gonna put a redstone torch, put a repeater going towards our sand block, and then put a repeater in between each sand block all the way to the end. So bop, 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 and like that. And then on the last one, we're gonna come out one more block and just put a piece of redstone dust here for now. Next, what I want you to do is take out your blocks again, and then we're gonna put a row of blocks above each one of these off torches. You know what, I'm just gonna use a different color. I think I've been overusing green a little bit too much. Let's just go with blue. This is pretty much for our reset. So I guess it's true, yeah, we could use a different color. This is for our reset in case we put the wrong number in. So just put a row of blocks above each and every single one of these lines. So just start from the side and go all the way down across each one. A lot of repeating. I made a new word, guys, repeating. A lot of repeating in this build. So just gotta put a row of blocks above each torch. Like so. Almost there. I wish I did not do nine numbers because this is taking forever. I just thought I should do nine numbers because, I mean, that's what I showed you guys. You know, why do like five or four numbers when I showed you nine numbers in the build? So right here is the last one. Come on. Come on. There we go. Now, above each one of these blocks, we're going to take out our redstone dust and put redstone dust along the tops of each one of these blocks. Like that. A lot of repeating. I would use splash potions, but the swirls annoy me. That's the only reason I don't do it, because in the videos, whenever I see those little swirls everywhere, it really, really annoys me. And then, of course, on this last line of blocks right here where I put these numbers, there's going to have to be a row of dust right up here as well. I just didn't break the blocks because I wanted to keep those numbers there, but there should be a row of dust around here as well. There should be nine numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like that. Next, what we're going to do is come down one more block right here off these off torches. So just put a blocks going off each one like that and put another piece of dust right here. Or redstone, whatever you want to call it. I like calling it dust. Next, what you're going to do is just take out your regular pistons again and face them upwards off each one of these blocks. Put sand on top of each one. And then put blocks in the middle of each one. So come out two off the back over here and then put blocks in the middle of each one. Then underneath the back block right here, we're gonna come underneath it a block and put a redstone torch here, put a piece of dust up here. And then we're gonna do the same thing like we did over there with the repeaters and just put a row of repeaters going down in between each sand block. So in between each sand block, put a repeater. And then on this last one, we're gonna put a piece of redstone dust right here, like that. Next, what I want you to do is, what are we gonna do? Okay, we're gonna make the reset, I guess, in case we get it wrong. So what you're gonna have to do is right off this block with the torch on it, we're gonna put a repeater going towards that side over there. Take a row of blocks and just bring it all the way down to this torch and then put redstone dust along all these blocks like that. Next, what I want you to do is put a piece of redstone dust to the left-hand side of the block with the torch on it. And we're gonna put two repeaters going into this block on four ticks delay. So put a repeater here and here, put them both on four ticks delay. Put a block next to this redstone dust here and put another repeater going into this block on one tick delay. Next, we're gonna take our redstone dust and we're gonna bring it all the way down to over here. And pretty much right here where this redstone dust is, we're just gonna come down a block and then come down another block, put redstone dust here and here. And then we're gonna put a repeater going this way on one tick delay. Actually, yeah. So pretty much if you're gonna make your numbers longer, just remember that a current can only travel 15 blocks. Every time you go down 15 rows of redstone, you have to put a repeater. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. See, it reaches. So if it would have went one more, I would have to put a repeater somewhere here inside this row of dust. Hopefully you guys know this already though. Hopefully I don't need to tell you that. Next, what we're gonna do is pretty much hook this side up to over here. So what we're gonna literally do is just come up here like this, come up a block, delete that block, there we go, and come up another block, and then just bring these all the way down to the reset, come down a block right here, put a repeater going into this redstone dust right here on one tick delay, and then just bring a row of redstone dust going all the way down to over here. Now, of course, you don't want these two connecting, so all you have to do is just take out blocks and put blocks right along the tops of these redstone dust, so these do not connect. You do not want these connecting to each other, so make sure you do that. Make sure you get rid of that. Next we're going to put in is our reset button. So to put your reset button in, all you have to do is literally come off any part of this redstone dust over here. So I'm just going to come off right here, and you know, I'm just going to come down like this, put some redstone dust here and here, and our reset button is going to go right here like that. So that's to reset it, and we should be done, guys. That should be every single thing. So now if I put my number in, mine should be 7. So we click 7. As you can see, the block went up on that side. 7, 1, 5, 9, 8, 2, 6, 9, and then if I click this one, it will end it. 2. See, it went all the way, and then it resets. All right, guys, so now we are completely done. So all we literally have to do is just make a monostable circuit or T flip-flop coming right off this part right here to open up a door or whatever you want it to open up. So literally what I'm going to do is just right off this redstone dust right here, I'm going to put a regular piston facing upwards with a piece of sand coming off of it. Then I'm just going to come out a block with a repeater coming out of the sand block on one tick delay. I'm going to put a sticky piston right, you know, let's put a block in front of our one tick delay repeater like this. Come down one with some redstone dust here, and then I'm just going to put a sticky piston going, let's just go this way, with a block, delete down a block with a torch here, put some redstone dust right here, and put, I'm just going to put a door right here, and then we're going to test it to make sure everything is working. So let me put in my code again. So it's going to be 7, 1, 5, 9, 8, 2, 6, 9, 2, and my door opened up. See that? And then of course any power going to this sticky piston will open and close. Like I said, pretty much you have to have an understanding of inputs and outputs to pretty much decide where you want your door to hook up to. You can hook this up to anything you really want to. But there you guys have it. That's how you build my 9-button combination lock. Of course, you can make it go like 500 numbers if you really want to. And if you don't really have an understanding of how like T flip-flops and monostable circuits and all that stuff work, just literally all you have to do is just look up T flip-flop on YouTube, and I'm sure you will easily come across one. I've done one in the past, very long time ago. But like I said, anything going to here will be your power source. This is your power source right here. Anything coming out of this. So like if you want to bring like a monostable circuit all the way down here or something like that, go right ahead. But there you guys have it. That is how you build my 9-button combination lock with an infinite amount of numbers. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave it a like and subscribe to stay tuned with my newest videos. All right, guys. Peace.